The Philippines rejects accusations from China that Manila is stirring up trouble in the South China Sea by conducting joint maritime patrols with the U.S. National Security Advisor Eduardo Año asserts the country's engagements with the U.S. are well within its rights as a sovereign and independent nation. Año adds the patrols were lawful and routine exercises aimed at enhancing interoperability and promoting regional peace. The Philippine Justice Department says it is ready to exact accountability against those responsible for the alleged cyanide use in Bajo de Masinloc. Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla says his agency is determined to address the supposed cyanide fishing of Chinese and Vietnamese fishermen in the area. Remulla adds they support the plan of President Marcos to file a case against China if warranted. A Kuwaiti court upholds the guilty verdict and sentence for the murder of overseas Filipino worker Julibee Ranara. The accused was sentenced to 15 years imprisonment for murder and 1 year for driving without a license. Department of Migrant Workers, OIC Hans Kaktak says they have informed the Ranara family of the ruling and assured them of the agency's continued support and assistance. Kaktak also says the Philippines and Kuwait are working towards the filing of civil action for damages against the father of the convicted perpetrator. Ranara was found dead in the desert in the Gulf State in January last year. An autopsy report showed she was pregnant. The killer was 17 at the time. Grave accusations from controversial televangelist Apollo Quiboloy. In a video released Wednesday, Quiboloy revealed a supposed plot to assassinate him, hatched by the U.S. government and aided by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Quiboloy is included in the FBI's most wanted list. He was indicted in the U.S. for sex trafficking and cash smuggling charges.
Ang kanila daw pong gagawin ng CIA, ng FBI, ng U.S. Embassy at State Department kasabwat ng ating gobyerno, ng Pangulong Marcos at ng First Lady at kung sino pa man ang nasa gobyerno, ako ay rendisyon ng kanilang gagawin. Ang rendisyon, ang ibig sabihin po, anumang oras, pwede lang pasukin ang aking compound at ako ay kidnapin. It's not only rendition, but also elimination. If it is possible, pwede nila akong i-assassinate.
As for the U.S. Embassy in the Philippines, it is confident Quiboloy will face justice for the heinous crimes he committed. Pastor Apollo Quiboloy also defended himself from allegations of rape and abuse from female members of his religious group, Kingdom of Jesus Christ. Sherry Ann Torres has more.
Kingdom of Jesus Christ leader Apollo Quiboloy breaks his silence Wednesday and rejects accusations of rape by some of his female followers. In a video statement sent to the media by the religious group, the 74-year-old televangelist insists allegations of sexual misconduct surfaced after he rejected the advances of his female followers. He claims his accusers are fighting over him because of his wealth and status.
Ako po ay hindi nag-asawa. Ngayon, inaakusahan ako ng napakaraming babae. Ito po ang kasalanan ko. Pinayaman ako ng Panginoon Diyos, akala nila sa akin. Single ako, kaya pinag-aagawan ako. Pagkatapos na ako ay maghihindi, mapapahiya, ibabaligtad nila sa akin.
Quiboloy also accuses the women of getting paid to make up stories. The pastor, however, did not say who paid the women to accuse him.
Pinag-aagawan nila ako dahil nananawagan sa mga magulang. Mayaman na tayo mga pag nangyari ito. Sabi ko hindi mangyayari yan kasi dedicated ako eh. Oh, napahiya, ngayon binayaran at ngayon binabaligtad ng lahat ng istorya.
In the same recorded message, Quiboloy also admits that KOJC members solicit funds. He however claims their collections go to disadvantaged sectors.
Pero yung amin pong sinosolicit, tingnan ninyo ang humanitarian na ginagawa namin. Ni Cinco wala kaming ninanakaw. Yung mga volunteers ko, walang sweldo.
araw at gabi.
Previously in two Senate hearings, witnesses who identified themselves as former KOJC members told the Committee on Women, Children, Family Relations and Gender Equality that they joined the organization because they were promised free education. However, the witnesses said they were made to beg and given a quota of 3,000 pesos a day. Failure to meet the quota means no meal for the day and repeated whipping. Kibuloy also defends Sunshine Media Network Incorporated or SMNI. SMNI is facing accusations of spreading fake news and violations of its congressional franchise.
Kung ako binigyan ng pampalipad na helicopter dito para mapuntang ko lahat ng aking satellites sa buong Mindanao, Pilipinas, kasalanan ko ba yun? Kasalanan ko ba na ako'y magkaroon paralan para makapag-aral ang mga bata na walang bayad? Kasalanan ko bang mayroong SMNI para hindi mabayaran?
Kibuloy also reiterates his challenge to lawmakers.
Hinamon ko na kayo, punta kayo sa korte. Ayaw ninyo, ikaw, Risa Hontiveros, ikaw, kayong tatlo dyan na nasa kongresong puro leftist. Hinahamon ko kayo, sabi ko, pumunta kayo sa korte. Sapagkat ang SMNI, walang kasalanan, ginurgur ninyo. Sapagkat idinadawit ninyo kami sa politika, nalis ninyo ang aming malayang pagpapahayag, ang aming press freedom, pati ang liberty ko na ang aking freedom, ang aking constitutional rights.
Senator Risa Hontiveros, who is leading the probe against Kibuloy and his organization, had this to say.
Huwag pong pa-victim. Ang hinihingi lang sa inyo ay humarap sa mga legal na proseso, kasama ang proseso ng Senate investigation. Huwag niyo pong dalhin sa lingwahe ng patayan, kahit yan ang nakasanayan niyo.
Hontiveros also warns Kibuloy of the repercussions of ignoring the Senate summons.
Dahil dinedman niya yung dalawang investigasyon ng komite, ay nag-issue ang Senado ng subpoena laban sa kanya. Isiserve po yan ng Senate Security. At binababalaan ko sila, no? Pag hindi sila nagpakita sa susunod na hearing, March 5, isa-cite ko sila in contempt, paaresto ko siya.
The senator also slams Kibuloy's reason for ordering members to solicit funds.
For the poor, may yumaman. At may guminhawa, hindi yung mga mahihirap dahil yung ating mga witnesses ay nanatiling mahirap at nananatiling mahirap. Pero may yumaman at yan si Apollo Kibuloy.
The self-styled son of God will have a chance to further respond to allegations against him in a March 5 Senate hearing and a March 12 House inquiry on the SMNI franchise. Lawmakers have repeatedly warned Kibuloy skipping these hearings will result in his arrest. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.
Over now to the House of Representatives, where lawmakers are rushing to pass a resolution seeking to amend economic provisions of the Constitution before the Holy Week. All lawmakers, led by House Speaker Martin Romualdez, will gather starting next week for charter change debates.
At lahat na. Hindi ito subcommittee, hindi lang standing, buong plenaryo, buong membership ng House of Representatives nandiyan na to show our seriousness and to show our desire to push for those economic provisions be enacted.
You will hear only the naysayers who have issues. And if those issues are valid, then the majority will probably relay their concerns to our leadership.
While the House version mirrors the Senate's resolution, they differ on the manner of changing the charter, with the lower chamber pushing for joint voting. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri believes the House is better off adopting the Senate's version.
I respect the House's social concern. We will just continue with our IBCs. Mas maganda yun. Pag natapos na, mas magandang i-adapt na lang para walang gulo, walang away, at hindi questionable, at hindi rin magkakaroon ng, uncertainty.
Dozens of House lawmakers from Mindanao signed a manifesto rejecting the proposed secession of the region. 53 out of the 60 House lawmakers who hail from Mindanao inked the manifesto describing the proposal as a step in the wrong direction. The document also called for the prosecution of those sowing disunity. Lanao del Norte First District Representative Muhammad Khalid Dimaporo now urges local executives in Mindanao to take a stand on the proposal of former President Rodrigo Duterte and former House Speaker Pantaleon Alvarez. A group raises concerns over the Philippine Education Department's move of reverting to the old school calendar. The DepEd adjusted the end of this current school year to May 31st instead of the original June 14 plan. The next school year will start on July 29. The National Parents Teachers Association warns adjusting the academic timeline could worsen learning gaps caused by the COVID-19 pandemic.
There is a learning gap with that time, learning gap natin sa public schools. Yun nga sana masolusyonan with regards to that learning gap na sana naman makop up kasi sa next school year, in-expect ng mga teachers na, alam mo, yung grade 5, in-expect ng mga teachers sa grade 6 that no, tapos yung topic in every subject.
Another group, meanwhile, calls on the DepEd to ensure that changes in the school calendar will not affect the rest days of teachers.
Kinasabi nila June 1 hanggang 30 ay activity free, pero labas po dyan ay obligado na pag-report din ng mga teacher, pero sana matiyak din po sana yung service credit.
Sinigurado natin na meron tayong at least 30 days na wala man lang mandatory or voluntary activities na ibibigay sa ating mga teachers para makapahinga sila.
Let's now get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Anna Clauren. Good morning, Anna.
Good morning, Bettina. Currently, the easter is still prevailing over the whole archipelago, bringing cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over Caraga and Davao region. Here in Metro Manila and the rest of the country, we're expecting a generally fair weather condition aside from isolated rain showers, mostly in the afternoon or in the evening. Currently, we're not monitoring any weather disturbance that may affect the country in the next 3 to 5 days. The temperature range here in Metro Manila is from 22 to 32 degrees Celsius. In Baguio City, 14 to 26 degrees. And in Tagaytay, is 20 to 30 degrees Celsius. And that's the latest from PAGASA. This is Anna Clauren. Good morning.
Thank you very much for that update, Anna.